Hey guys, it's Hillary. It's Friday. It's another Confessions of a Peacemaker video. And what is my confession this week? This one is gonna hurt a little because my confession is I am terrible at handling money, budgeting, finances. Watch and find out if it's a type 9 thing or just a Hillary thing. Okay guys, so I've got my coffee. You guys know this is a more relaxed video. It's Friday. I just like to spend time with you guys, get a little raw and honest, and go through some confessions. And so like I said at the beginning, today's confession is I am terrible with money, and we're gonna get down to the bottom of it and figure out why. All right, so my biggest struggle, I would say, is just like sitting down at the computer and logging into my bank account and settling down to do the budget. Like sometimes that's my biggest hurdle, just getting there, just actually doing the work and figuring out a budget. I put it off, I avoid it, it overwhelms me, it feels like a lot, it disrupts my peace. Like guys, I don't know if you can relate to me right now, whether you are a 9 or you aren't a 9, but this is definitely a struggle I have had my entire life. And a lot of times I find myself just closing my eyes, pretending everything's okay and not dealing with it. Can anybody relate? Put a raised hand down in the comments box if you can relate with me. Don't let me feel alone, guys. Okay, so I wanna kind of go into why I have these money issues. And there's a few reasons. I've thought about it, and one of the reasons is, in the past, my people-pleasing has got out of control, guys. Yes, everything that came my way. I used to have like trips come my way and, you know, oh, you wanna go do this? You wanna go to the movies? You wanna go to dinner? Big things, little things, all things. I never said no, I always said yes. And more than likely, I didn't even want to do it. And I probably didn't even have the money to do it. But the people-pleasing part of me always found myself saying yes, even at the cost of my own bank account. My personality is just like laid back and accommodating and has been people pleasing. I've gotten a lot better at that, but I really believe that some of the debt that I've gotten myself into is because of my own habits. I'm not gonna lie, I feel even overwhelmed just even talking about this today. I'm like, oh, I just wanna kinda like, no, do we have to talk about money, you know? But we're gonna get down to the nitty gritty because I don't want you guys to feel alone if you are dealing with something similar as me. Now, when I look back at my life, I can see some really pivotal moments that got me like out of control with money, spending too much money, getting myself into debt. And they were usually big events in my life. Some of them good and some of them extremely hard. Like for example, we moved to Alaska, I don't even know, like 8 or 9 years ago, 10 years ago, I'm not for sure when, but we moved to Alaska and it was such a huge move. And when I got there, I ended up dealing with some seasonal depression and different things, even though, you know, there were some great things about Alaska, I definitely just buried my head in the sand and didn't pay attention to our budget and our money and how much we had and just used credit cards and kind of, I think, in my opinion, got out of control. And then another time, my husband lost his job. And this happened around 5 years ago. He had been with the company for a long time and he ended up, you know, losing his job. And honestly, again, that was another pivotal moment where like, it was like, I don't want to deal with the emotions of this and what this really is. And, oh, just put it on credit or use the money we have, but use all of it, you know? And so that's another time I can think of that I just wasn't good with money. And then the third time that came to mind is I actually had been doing pretty good with money and had a good plan. And my mom ended up getting cancer and then passing away. And after that, it just, life was so overwhelming that the last thing I could pay attention to was money. And I don't know if you can relate to this. I don't know if, you know, this has more to do with a 9 or just everybody in general, but those are some big moments in my life that caused me to ignore my budget, ignore everything, and get into some debt. I just didn't want money to affect my peace of mind at the moment. Buying stuff helped me numb out. And I found myself doing it all the time, buying stuff that I needed and then I didn't need. But then I will say it got so overwhelming that I had to deal with it because you can only do that for so long, right? You know, and to be honest, like I'm a procrastinator. Even without all of that, I can procrastinate. I could be disorganized and I just want to pretend everything's okay sometimes. I would have big stacks of mail that I hadn't really gone through. It's like I would initially go through it and be like, oh, okay, I don't have to deal with this right now. I'll deal with this another time. So I'm like seriously exposing myself right now. This feels so exposing. But again, I want to use my journey and what I've went through to maybe give you, a head start, a plan, to move forward. So, okay. So the one thing I will say, I didn't actually like miss payments or anything. I am super into my credit score and wanting to have a good credit score. And so that was always important to me, but I would wait till the last minute to pay things. And I don't know, I just always, and I still feel this way where it's like the bills are the last thing in the world that I want to even focus on or do in the budget. I would say when I'm not the healthiest, that's when I'm like the laziest with my finances. The biggest hurdle for me personally is just sitting down and doing it. Cause once I do it, I'm all in. As soon as the pain gets strong enough or big enough or whatever the right word is, I will sit down and I will go through all our bills and I'll write a plan and everything and I'll go all in. And so I don't want to leave you guys just hanging of like, okay, this is what I've been through. I'm actually excited because I feel like I've come up with a good plan for 2021. I'm feeling pretty motivated, which when I'm motivated, I gotta jump on that train. I gotta stay on that train because it doesn't happen all the time. I came across an article when I was kind of looking into type nines and finances and if that's an issue for type nines or any of the types. And Jasmine Clark wrote an article for the Financial Diet. I don't know like much more than that about the article, but I'll link it down below because she goes through all the types and how they handle money and good advice for them. And so not just the nines, all the types. And so I actually found it extremely helpful. And I just want to say hey to Jasmine if you are watching this because I know you are a subscriber and I really appreciate you. And I appreciate this article because it got me excited about figuring out how to be healthier in my finances. So the idea she had for the type nine is create a financial vision board. And I was like, okay, yes, that totally speaks my language. Putting something in front of me every single day keeps me on track. Now you're not gonna be able to see this, but on this wall over here in my office, I have goals that I wrote for 2020. And so I wrote them down. I wrote my word of the year, which was breakthrough, and different things that I wanted to see and experience in my personal life and my business life. And then I wrote 15 like pivotal things I wanted to reach. And I'm two away from everything that I wrote down. And so keeping it in the forefront of me and me being able to see it daily is what helps me. Otherwise I fall asleep to it and I forget about it. When she talked about creating a financial vision board, I'm like, yes, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna create that board and stick it on this wall. And I think that that will actually help me. I just think it's creative, it's fun. And if I have to look at those financial goals every day, I will have a better chance at having success. And I think for type nines and maybe all types, just if you're gonna do something like this or if you struggle in this area, start brick by brick, step by step, one thing at a time. Because if I look at the whole wall in front of me, I just won't do it. I'm like, it's too overwhelming, I can't. But if I break it down into bite-sized pieces, I know myself enough to know I will do it. And so I hope that helps you. If you're struggling in this area, just start little by little. And I think the last thing is find an accountability partner. I know for me, if I have somebody who knows my goals and knows things that I want to reach and or just even knows this is my struggle area, having them know that and know that I'm going to ask them, you know, to hold me accountable can help me stay on track. Not 100% because sometimes I could still be like, nah, I don't care. But I do think that that can help. If you do struggle in this area, find somebody that doesn't struggle in this area. I think pairing those two types together would definitely help the type that does struggle. So I'd love to know what's your type and what keeps you on track? What plans do you have in place? I'd love to know your type and how you handle money. And if you are type nine, does this help you? Do you struggle in this area? And if you do, I'm right there with you. I just wanted to be real and authentic with you guys today and let you know, like, this has definitely been a struggle for me. Sometimes it's not, and sometimes it is. You know, I just feel like, you know, there's valleys and peaks and whatever. And it does depend on the health of myself if I struggle or not with it. So anyways, I hope this helped you today. I hope me being authentic and real with you helped you to be authentic and real in the moment and not feel shame and not feel embarrassed. Like, this is a real thing. And real events can cause things to happen, and to look inside yourself and ask yourself, like, you know, if you are struggling, like, what else is going on? What's in your heart? You know, what do you need to reach out to a friend and talk about? So that's why I do it. Anyways, well, I don't know if you guys saw, I announced this in, I think it was the video earlier in this week. I'm about to launch an Etsy shop and sell stickers, and you might have seen some. This one says, be kind. I have, you know, stickers for each type. I don't know, coffee, hustle, sleep, repeat. I don't know. I just think it's cute. You know, little name. I don't know if you can even see those, but water bottle stickers, laptop stickers. Go follow me on my social media account, Hillary_McCaskey_coaching or Enneagram and Coaching. Both of those are my social media accounts. You will find more information about when I'm going to be launching my Etsy shop and when you can buy these stickers. It is coming soon. But that's all I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please push like if you did. It helps my channel out so much. And if you've gotten to this point and you're like, wait, I'm not even a subscriber, push that subscribe button if you want to see more content like this. Until next time, guys. Bye, guys.